go for it again with the devil strong sword. Grazie. My thanks. I'm your man now, Capitano.
Dear, Mr. Duncan Walpole of England to see the governor. I believe he is expecting me.
Sí, señor Walpole. Entre, por favor. ¿Ese es el hombre? ¿El... cómo lo llamabas? ¿Asesino?
Sí, Duncan Walpole. Debería haber llegado hace muchos días.
No me gusta que los extranjeros se paseen por nuestra...
No me fío de ellos.
Cállate. El gobernador tiene invitados. Todos franceses e ingleses.
Parece un hombre rudo. Le suponía un aspecto más... respetable.
Llévame ese ser altamente. Sé indulgente con él.
Good morning, sir. Would I be correct in thinking you are Duncan?
I am indeed.
I thought as much. Woods Rogers.
A pleasure.
The same. I must say, my wife has a terrible eye for description.
I'm sorry.
My wife. You met her some years ago at the Percy's Masquerade Ball.
Ah, quite.
She called you devilishly handsome. Obviously, a lie to stoke my jealousy. Julianne, our guest of honor has arrived, Mr. Duncan Walpole.
Julianne Ducasse. I hope your conversion to our order is an honest one. I have no love for assassins, but even less for liars.
I have not come to disappoint.
Up for a bit of sport, Duncan?
The old man isn't ready just yet.
You've got my two best pairs of matched pistols, Duncan. So handle them with care.
If I had eight, I'd treat each as my own son.
Pull off a few shots if you like. Get a feel for it.
I once fought beside a man who carried nine on his person. They were a boon in battle, but hindered his ability to swim. Sadly.
I did kick, yes?
I long for the day where one firearm carries four bullets, and not the opposite.
I have a friend in England who would like to meet Julian. James Puckle. He's working on something extraordinary.
Magnifique!
Duncan,
Where are your wrist blades? I've never seen an assassin so ill-equipped.
Ah, damaged sadly beyond all repair.
Have your choice.
Where did you find all these?
I did not find them. I took them. These are souvenirs. Two blades, as is the custom, oui?
Custom, aye.
Duncan, will you indulge us with a demonstration of your techniques?
Well,
We must. We put together a training course in anticipation of your arrival. It would be a shame to leave here without seeing you in action.
Yes, of course. Well, I mean, if there is time, I would gladly, show you what I know.
Here. You see? Situation is well suited to your skills.
Have a go. A blade in a crowd is always the simplest. Nothing grandiose, just quick and clean.
Show us another technique.
Quite ingenious to use bales of hay for cover, don't you think? God, that's the spirit! Secrecy. The advantage of surprise cannot be overstated, isn't that so? Especially around a blind corner. God blind me, that's a clever trick.
Your aerial kills have a poetic beauty, despite their conspicuous quality. Would you show us?
Magnifique. Is it also possible to deliver a killing blow at high speed? Mon Dieu, such a powerful strike!
Fascinating!
The assassins have trained you well, Duncan. You chose a perfect time to leave them behind.
At great risk, I imagine. Betraying the assassins is never good for one's health.
Well, neither is drinking liquor, but I am drawn to its dangers all the same. And what is your business here, sir? Are you an associate of the governor's, or a pending acquaintance like myself?
Guns, blades, cannons, grenados. Anything that may kill a man, I am happy to provide.
A smuggler of sorts. And how is your wife these days, Captain Rogers? Is she, here, in Havana?
I trust she's well, but I wouldn't know. I've been in Madagascar some 14 months hunting pirates. It took some work to dislodge the criminals there, but we managed it. In future, I hope to use these same tactics throughout the West Indies.
And how did you deal with their kind?
Very simply. Most pirates are as ignorant as apes. I merely offered them a choice. Take a pardon and return to England, penniless, but free men. Or be hanged by the neck until dead.
Oh. I imagine Nassau would be your next target.
Very astute, Duncan, indeed.
Best of luck with that.
Grandmaster Torres! Mr. Duncan Walpole has arrived.
See. You were expected 1 week ago.
Apologies, Governor. My ship was set upon by pirates. We were scuttled. I arrived only yesterday.
Unfortunate. Forgive my caution, but were you able to salvage from these pirates the items you promised me?
Yes, sir. I was.
Incredible. The assassins have more resources than I had imagined, but... not nearly enough to deter us. It is a pleasure to meet you at last, Duncan. You are most welcome. Come, gentlemen. We have much to discuss. Convened at last, and in such continental company. England, France, Spain, citizens of sad and corrupted empires. But you are Templars now, the secret and true legislatures of the world. Please, hold out your hands. Mark and remember our purpose. To guide all wayward souls till they've reached a quiet road. To guide all wayward desire till impassioned hearts are cool. To guide all wayward minds to safe and sober thought. By the Father of Understanding's light, let our work now begin. Decades ago, the Council entrusted me with the task of locating in these West Indies a forgotten place our precursors once called the Observatory. See here. Look up on these images and commit them to memory. They tell a very old and important story. For two decades now, I have endeavored to locate this observatory, a place rumored to contain a tool of incredible utility and power. It houses a kind of armillary sphere, if you like. A device that would grant us the power to locate and monitor every man and woman on Earth, whatever their location. Will you imagine what it would mean to have such a power? With this device, there would be no secrets among men. No lies, no trickery. Only justice, pure justice. This is the Observatory's promise, and we must take it for our own.
Do we know its whereabouts?
We will soon. For in our custody is the one man who does, a man named Roberts, once called a sage.
It has been 45 years since anyone has seen a true sage. Can you be sure this one is authentic?
We are confident he is.
The assassins will come for him.
Indeed they will. But thanks to Duncan and the information he has delivered, the assassins won't be a problem for much longer. All will be made clear tomorrow, gentlemen, when you meet the sage for yourselves. Until then, let us drink. Let us find the observatory together. For with its power, kings will fall, clergy will cower, and the hearts and minds of the world will be ours. Rest well, Duncan. Tomorrow the treasure fleet arrives, and with it, your reward. After which we will discuss further schemes.
I look forward to it.
Excelente. Meet me down at the docks first thing tomorrow morning.
Governor Torres requests your presence at the docks near the Castillo. First thing tomorrow morning.
I do not know who you seek, but by all that is holy, it is not me. Captain Kenway, just in time. I'll see you back aboard.
Soy demasiado bueno.
Good morning, Duncan. Just over here.
Edward? Hello, Edward! I found a man to purchase my remaining sugar! Quite a coup, I must say!
He just called you Edward.
Oh, that's the merchant who sailed me here. Out of caution, I gave him a false name.
Ah. Well done.
We'll catch up on it later.
Very punctual, Duncan. This way. Here he is. A man both Templars and assassins have sought for over a decade. I am told your surname is Roberts. Is this so? You recognize this, I think.
According to old tales, the blood of a sage is required to enter the observatory.
We have the key. Now we need only its location. Perhaps Mr. Roberts will be eager to provide it. Transfer him to my residence.
Such a fuss over one man. Is the observatory really such a grand prize?
Si, sin duda. The observatory was a tool built by the precursor race. Its worth is without measure.
Precursor race? I see.
One of your early letters mentioned a desire to kill the Mayan mentor, Atabai. Were you able to carry out this contract before coming here?
I was not, no. Too many complications along the way.
A pity. But the map you delivered with the blood vial will see that job finished.
Aye. That's the idea.
I don't like this route, Torres. We're exposed. Something is wrong. Stay close, Grandmaster.
I feel it too. Do not let them get their hands on the Sage, at whatever cost.
Assassins! Oh. Above! They're on the rooftops!
Watch the steps and alleys. They could be anywhere.
Assassins! Above! They're on the rooftops! Don't expect mercy!
Watch the street finale. They could be anywhere.
You're a nimble one, I'll give you that. Hang back and make this easy on both of us, mate.
Stop, or I'll kneecap you!
Well done, lapdog.
Quiet.
We'll see him to the prisons, Grandmaster.
Double the watch.
Well, I'll be buggered. What an active day we've had, gents.
See, beset on all sides by our enemies, we must be more cautious.
I do wish I could remain to see our drama done, but I must avail myself of these winds and sail for England.
By all means, Captain, speed and fortune to you.
With luck. Return myself a governor. And with my idiot king's blessing, no less. Adios.
As for you, Mr. Walpole, I consider this the first payment in a long-term investment. Gracias.
Obliged.
I would like you to be present for the interrogation tomorrow. Call around noon.
Yes, sir.
Último aviso. ¿Quieres vivir?
Lo siento.
¡Vamos, obedece!
Lo siento.
¡Vamos, obedece!
¿Estás sordo? ¡Obedece!
¿Me estás escuchando?
¡Eh! Lo siento.
Thank you.
what I think of your orders, Captain. Grazie. My thanks. I'm your man now, Capitano.
¡Quieto!
¿De verdad vas a intentar escapar de nosotros?
¡Ya has vivido demasiado!
¿Crees que puedes despistarnos?
¡Ah! De todas formas, seguro que les guste.
Un problema con los asesinos.
Peligroso.
Only my cold, dead corpo will ever come with you, cazzo. Grazie. My thanks. I'm your man now, Capitano.
Thank you.
irlandeses, así que seguro que llegan tarde. Si el Torres estuviera aquí para hacerse cargo de esto.
lo haría.
Un poco imprudente.
Todo un campeón con las botas.
Join me for a drink, Edward.
God sink me for this pittance. 1,000 reals for those maps. That's what? £100 at most. How's a man supposed to become rich in these times with a miser like Torres running the world?
Have you ever, you ever worked on a plantation before?
You know what I'm thinking? I'd like to see this observatory the governor's going on about. He said it were like a device. I could follow people around and show where they were.
A ludicrous idea. Imagine my wife with such an advantage over me.
Imagine what a thing like that would be worth. Sell that to the right person and I'd be the richest pirate privateer in the West Indies. I'll catch you up, Bonnet. There's a sage in that house I must speak to in private.
¡Alto! ¡Mirad! ¡Allí!
Ni idea. Solo he oído rumores de que hay piratas en la zona.
Espero que llegue. Casi estoy sin Blanca y le debo 4 reales a Mendoza.
Ni idea. Solo he oído rumores de que hay piratas en la zona.
Espero que llegue. Casi estoy sin Blanca y le debo 4 reales a Mendez.
¡Más rápido! ¡No debemos perderlo!
alboroto?
¿Últimas palabras?
Oye, te hemos echado de menos. Creía que habías desertado.
What is your true name, Rogue?
It's her. Captain Pissoff.
Me and her Pov Pissoff.
Where is this sage? You set him free.
I had nothing to do with that. Much as I wish I did.
Take him to the ports. Send him to Sevilla with the treasure fleet.
Wait now! I delivered your treasures, didn't I?
You did, yes. But you robbed us of Duncan Warble.
Despicable display. This tosspot is a ruined man, Caroline. Unfit for life on land, much less at sea. If he goes to the West Indies, it's you who'll suffer.
Father! Father! Come, love. Up with you now.
That old muckworm! He's wrong about me!
I hope it's so.
You believe me, don't you? Can you not see me?
standing out there on the deck of a ship that's sliding into port. And there I am, a man of quality, with 1,000 doubloons spilling from my pockets like drops of rain. I can see it.
La cena. Cómetela rápido.
You hungry?
Now what's your plan, mate?
Find a weapon and steal a ship.
Que Dios nos ayude. No me gusta la pinta de esa tormenta.
Parece que se está desviando al oeste, hacia el golfo. Quizás...
Unlucky lads. Christ, the seas are uneasy today.
We're stealing a brig. Hey, take what you need.
Won't be a minute.
There's many prisoners held on these ships. Set them free, and they'll sail with us, no question.
So that's the idea, then. Free what men we can, then find a fast ship to flee in.
Aye, there's a brig in this fleet. I'll make my way to it.
There's a catch to this favor. You're sailing with me.
I'd follow you to hell for this, mate.
Come on, lads. If we're to drown today, it won't be here.
Casi tenemos encima la tormenta.
¿Y qué pasa con los prisioneros?
Que se ahoguen. Mejor ellos que nosotros.
There's a brig nearby just waiting for us to take her.
ella! ¡Vuelve aquí! ¡Maldita sea!
Minutos partiremos.
De retorcerte, pirata. ¿Me entiendes? No te muevas.
Going topside. Be ready.
Lads! Save your singing for Davy Jones, you juggabats! It's a hard wind coming!
The man speaks true, you lot weigh anchor. As for the rest, half on the foremast and half of the main. Let's outrun this hurricane!
Keep watch on those galleons. See they don't give us trouble.
They won't. Far too small for this weather.
Wise, mate. We're up against it here.
These men know their place. They'll see us home.
Enemy's firing!
I see it.
Water spout!
Those bad men, stay away!
It's not looking good.
Steady as she goes, man. We will be dragged down to our death camp.
By God, we pulled this one straight from the teeth of Neptune. I'm Edward. Much thanks for your aid back there.
Aduwale.
You ever been to Nassau, Aduwale?
Not yet.
By God, she took some knocks, didn't she? I think I'll keep her.
All hands aft, lads! Taking this one home.
I made my choice, Addy. I'm calling her the Jackdaw. A sly bird I loved as a child back in Swansea.
A dark little creature, no?
Did it rub you wrong when I took this brig as mine own?
It was the sort of rub I have learned to endure, sailing among faces of such fairness.
It's true. Most of these men wouldn't accept you as a captain. So what fair role would complement such unfairness?
I'll be your quartermaster. Nothing less.
All right. And as quartermaster, have you any immediate counsel for this Tyro captain?
Rest and repast would do us good before Nassau. Water for drinking. Hunting for food and repairs.
Well reasoned, sir. Hunting, it shall be. We'll find a decent place to drop anchor. I spied a few items in the hold earlier. Powder and a few pistols. I think I'll fashion a second holster if I can.
It's a good...
Wow.
one you find laughable.
Could we talk a moment about the condition of the ship?
What's the trouble?
I had a walk about the gun deck this morning, and couldn't stand for what I saw. A clutter of linstocks heaped like tinder, and one with a slow match, still burning.
Christ.
And just nearby, two barrels of gunpowder, closer than man and wife, fit to explode at the touch of a spark.
We'll stow ours good and proper.
As for the cannons, they might as well be tossed. Clogs touch holes in need of scraping, corrosion on the bodies, barrel swabs as naked as knives, and breech ropes so rotted, I could use them for knitting yarn. The short of it is, we need good equipment kept in fine condition. But we cannot win every battle with snares and shouts. So worry about your own armament when it suits you. But don't forget about your jackdaw as well.
Cruise up! Ease her sticks! Get the mains free!
Bearing down on last.
Shorten sail! Kill off the squall!
Keep performing!
Mains out! Let's go! Fall all!
Ahoy aloft! Bring it all in!
Captain's not in himself.
Thank you.
That's booty.
Ahoy, Captain. Find what you need.
My needs and wants are oceans apart, mate. But I did fashion myself a new holster. All I need now is a pistol to lie in it.
Yeah. Taken from the holds, just as you said.
A little more than a blowpipe. But it'll do. So, are we rested? Or should we idle a while longer?
Best way anchor. I think the crew is itching to reach civilization.
You'll find no civilization in Nassau. But it's a fine place to be merry all the same.
It is time to go now.
Go on, Captain Queernabs. Tell me I'm under arrest.
Tell me!
Them your breads.
Fly away, boyo! Back to your master!
Aye. We was privateers together before the wars ended. I'll see you ashore.
By God, you're a sight for salty eyes. Come you in and have a drink.
Morning, all.
I can't wait. Who's this?
Adewale, the Jackdaw's quartermaster.
Jackdaw. You named your brig after a poxy bird.
Ade, these lads are the better part of our growing confederacy here. Ed Thatch, Ben Hornigold, James Kidd.
You let him carry a pistol, do you?
Peace, Ben.
Ade saved my life. And now we're looking to find a crew to fill out the rest of my ship.
Well, there's scores of capable men about. But use caution. A shipload of the King's sailors showed up before night back, causing trouble and knocking about like they own the place.
Right. I'll see who I can muster.
Send any men you find to the Jackdaw.
Cheers, Ade.
Thank you.
right, lads. Seems he's gonna be an absolute old tower.
You'll be swimming through your own innards.
Leave him just here. Where's he going?
Yeah. I got him sighted.
Thanks. Kenway, isn't it? I'm with you.
Don't play somewhere else.
I'll teach you.
They need to hang him.
This pirate bear. You're in my sight, sweetheart. Yeah.
happening, Kenway? Come, fast! The soldiers have kept the man in irons. They need to hang him.
In me sight!
Come with me, or pull the pole.
Hello, Lloyd.
If you like the drapes so much, why not buy the rug?
What a... Well, I certainly hope so, you useless masculine appendage. If you don't find them, I'm leaving you. And I don't care what your mama thinks.
Baby, you
deaf
man!
Silly boy! Is that why your hands so callous? What a waste!
Wouldn't a gentleman of your substance fancy escorting me home?
If cleanliness is close to godliness, I promise I'm heaven sent! I can even tell you all the tales your mama did.
For a fee. That's the last warning. Did you bleed it, Amy?
I'm terribly well informed of all country matters, I assure you. Ever had the pleasure of two vixens in your den?
That's my last warning.
If you like the drapes so much, why not buy the rug?
Rest of the day, dear Eva.
Oh dear, I seem to have misplaced my chastity. Help me, please.
You look tense. Come, let me help you unwind.
Captain Kenway, come fast. The soldiers have cut the man in the
iron.
Oh, God, please listen. I never meant anything by it.
Your
Captain Kenway, come fast. There's soldiers have trapped a man in irons. They need to hang him.
I think I can hit him.
Captain Kenway, come fast! The soldiers have trapped a man in irons. We need to hang him! Oh God, please listen!
He's mine! Clear shot!
Yeah.